Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. 你们好. 안녕하세요. 안녕하세요. 好, 早晚. Who I miss? Today. Okay. Cool. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 2019 Artists Korea International Symposium. My name is Sung Chan Yu, the doctoral arts student of Aju University School of Medicine. I'd like to express my hopeful appreciation to the representative of the 2019 RDC Korean International Symposium around the world, to the experts in this field and the industry for attending this symposium. Really, thank you for you guys. I appreciate your time taking off from your busy schedules to join us today. We also hope you will find the program that we have lined up to you to be fruitful and engaging. So we'll now start opening ceremony. Please, I want to introduce Romy Bak. So Professor Romy Bak will open the symposium. He is the president of Seoul National University Bundang Hospital, is a world-renowned craniofacial, plastic, and palate surgeon. He has over 100 publications at the world's top medical journals and actively participates both domestic and international academic society. Please welcome him with a big round of applause.
Morning, friends, colleagues. It's my great pleasure to be here with you today at the opening of the 2019 Odyssey Korea International Symposium. They will discuss the promise of distributed health connect, health network, and the observational research, and how we can work together to realize that goal. I'd like to thank the visionary leaders of Odyssey, including Dr. George Lapsik of Columbia University, and prominent speakers from Australia, China, Japan, Singapore, Netherlands, Germany, Taiwan, USA, and Korea for engaging in wonderful work to advance, spread, and utilize CDM. I also like to thank Professor Leung Bak and Dr. Sang-ho Lee, Dr. Yun Jung-he, for giving us the will to drive the nationwide CDM infrastructure. And last but not least, thanks go to the support and the cooperation of everyone in our CDM community from home and abroad. I hope this year's symposium shall serve as a foundation for constructive and impactful scientific research using CDM-based health big data. Also, I hope we can discuss ways to bridge the business community to tap into the vast resource to fulfill the promise of distributed health network. The organic global cooperation and networking of the international CDM community has always inspired me, and I look forward to seeing those activities mature and strengthened. Thank you all, and I hope all of you great success in your work and research. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Bak. Next, the opening lecture will begin. Professor Leung Bak, who is my boss, will give us an opening lecture titled Welcome to the Korean Odyssey's Journey. He is a director and professor of the Department of Biomedical Informatics at Aju University School of Medicine. He introduced Odyssey into Korea and established Odyssey Korean community. Let's give him a big round of applause.
Do you love this scarf? Okay, this is a present for all of you. And welcome to Odyssey Korea 2019. Today we have 330 participants from 9 countries. So this is huge. I think also although it is a start, but I think it's a big success. And if we divide them, about 80% of them come from the academia, and 17% come from the industry, and 5% come from the government. And of them, 80 persons are medical doctors that take 24% of the whole participant of this symposium. In Addis Korea, during the last 1 year, we had more than 40 activities in Korea. If we divide it, we had 17 seminar and symposium, 6 leadership meetings, 15 tutorials, 2 data sun, 1 international symposium, this one, and we received 6 awards from various academic society. This symposium cannot be opened without the help of our precious sponsors, including EVDNET and Aju University as platinum sponsor, Jeonbuk National University Hospital and Bundang Seoul National University as a gold sponsor, and Seoul National University Hospital, Catholic University Hospital, Asan Medical Center, Samsung Medical Center, and Hanmi Healthcare as silver sponsor, and Smart Medical Security Forum as bronze the sponsor. Would you please give them the big hands to them? I would like to share the hidden history of the artist career. You may wonder how the artist career started. When it was 2010, I participated in the MedInfo that was held in Cape Town of South Africa. At there, I attended a symposium there. I saw a person present this paper about the research what he had. This is about the method for drug safety signal detection in longitudinal observational database, longitudinal gamma Poisson shrinkage and Leopard algorithm. It was very hard for me to understand. Basically, it is about how to detect adverse drug reaction from the electronic medical record. Here, he also introduced about the OMAP. At that time, the OMAP just started, so OMAP. And this algorithm, LGPS plus Leopard, win the prize or beating the OMAP Cup. So it was very impressive to me. Okay, he's the Martin Shumi who presented this topic in there. But it was too hard for me, so I asked a lot to him. And after the meeting, I asked a lot. But still, I can't understand what this algorithm means. So it takes a long time before I can fully understand this all of the algorithm. And I heard the OMAP at that time, so I searched the Google, but I cannot find any information in the Google at that time. And then, however, with the inspiration you introduced at that time, I got a government grant from the government with this concept. It's very similar to OMAP, but it is different. We, of the 3 hospitals, we converted each hospital's clinical data warehouse into our own CDM, not OMAP CDM. So we converted each data into CDM, and we tried to mix them all together to make a big repository of some kind of CDM at the time. So this was 3-year project. Why I'm doing this, I met Martin Shumye in the ESP meeting that was held at Barcelona 2012. I met there again. He presented something. I can't remember what it was, but he presented. So I met again. And 2013 in Montreal, Canada, we met again. At the places I introduced the project, what I am doing, the integrated clinical data warehouse project using the CDM, and we discussed, and he brought the Patrick Ryan Takeda, so we discussed a lot, and I could learn more about the OMAP CDM. So after I coming back, with the help of the Martin Shimier, and Patrick Ryan, and George Ripse, we started converting our Aju University Hospital data into OMAP CDM, we started. And after 1 year, there was the first face-to-face meeting at the Columbia University, October 2014. We attended here with the CDM, we already converted. 아주 유니버설 하스피탈 데이터 인투 모브시디엠 at that time. So participated the meeting and demonstrated our the system to the public, to the members. I think he must be George Lipsey. Christian Ray here. I can recognize you back. John Duke here. Peter Lindbergh here. Yeah, so at the time, that was the first publicly available acne in the world. So I got a lot of notice from the audience. And after coming back, I got power, the energy that I can move forward. So after coming back, I pushed forward and tried to introduce OMOP-CDM into the Korean society. And after 2 years, the International the RGC Korean Internet Symposium that was held in 2017, Martin Shumie, Mark Schuchard, Patrick Ryan come to Korea and introduced the RGC into the Korean community. Also, they led the several tutorials to the Korean communities. And then 1 year later, the Jang Lee and Usman Iqbal, you are here, there. Usman Iqbal invited Martin Shumie, Chen, and me to the Taiwan, so we also introduced the Odyssey into the Taiwan community. Also, the Martin Shumie had the tutorial, such a tutorial to the community. And then after this meeting, Martin Shumie, me, Chen, had the dinner in a street restaurant, very similar to this one, not the exact one, but here we discussed about the necessity of the book on the Odyssey. So, and after discussing it, just I forgot about that, but Martin Shumie didn't forget the discussion. So after he coming back to the Netherlands here, 2018 December, he started writing something. What? I don't know what it is. He started something here. And I think they started, the Odyssey community started the writing the book of the Odyssey here. The first wave, that means the draft writing. And the second wave, that means the peer review like that. And the editing process. So while doing that, they pulled more than 550 commits during that. And I can find that he committed almost 250. Christina committed 81, David Madigan 44, Mark Schuchard 28, and about 18 contributors, the researchers contributed to write this book. And this is the result. The Book of Odyssey was published 2.5 months ago. So you can buy this book. It is only $10, so you can buy, or even you can download it freely in the website. So if you are confident, fluent in English, then use this book. And then, after coming back to the Korea, Chen and I discussed how about to translate the Book of Odyssey into Korean. Here, as you see, this is the date of the publish of the Book of Odyssey. So after coming back, Chen and I discussed a lot. So we decided to translate the Book of Odyssey into Korean. So as you see, the first wave means the draft translation and peer review and editing process. Here, Chen committed 131 and me 24, and Lee Sun-kyung 68, John Myung-won 8 commit like that. So about 20 persons involved translating the Book of Odyssey into Korean. So this is the result. We have Odyssey Bible. Odyssey Bible. We have. Okay. So in considering all of the relationship and tie with the Martin Shumie, I think he contributed a lot to the birth of the Korea Odyssey. Would you come in front of the stadium?
That's hilarious.
Okay, thank you for your contribution.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I'll keep it very brief. So yes, it's been amazing to see the growth here in Odyssey Korea. Every time that I talk to my friend Ray Wong, I can't help but be blown away by the progress that's being made here. And you truly are the leaders of Odyssey. And I look forward to where you're going in the future, and I'm looking forward to hearing all the great new progress that's made here today. Thank you.
Thank you
so much. And, oh, I really love this. But I have the first copy.
Yes, that is the first copy. If you open the book in the second page, the inner, no. I have another one. In the second inner page, you can find a carton. Do you know what the carton means? This Avengers of the Odyssey here. Do you know who he is? He is George Lipset here. He's there, okay? And in the center is a Christian Lake. Chen is here, Chen. You can easily find him. Okay. Most of the authors are now in this the stadium. Peter Rimbeck and Patrick Ryan, Mui Banjant, and Martin Shimie. All the Avengers are here. So this symposium is so great. And she's the artist who draw this the cartoon. She's as well the artist as well as the data scientist. So she's a wonderful member of the Odyssey. She lives in the United Kingdom. So next year, the European Odyssey will held in UK. So you can meet her at the meeting. So if you go to the European Odyssey, then please take this book and request her the signature on your book. Okay. So we have many distinguished speakers from all over the world. Professor George Lipset from the Columbia University. He's the chair of the whole the Odyssey, and the Patrick Ryan, Peter Lindbeck. He is in charge of the Eden project that's converting 12 European countries' electronic health record data into the MOPS-EDM. And Christian Ray, Martin Shumier, Mui Banjant, Erica Bruce from the United States. Si Hua represents the China Odyssey. She is here. And Sang Li is the officer who covers all the grants on this CDM in Korea. And Yun Jung He, she is the director, chair of the HERA. The research center. Okay, Morning Peng from the Singapore, and Professor Nicole Pratt from the Australia, and Akira Izumi from Japan. So today we have lots of distinguished speakers from the world. Okay, we now have the platform named FIDANET. If you log in to this site, then you can see your associated affiliation, and you can use your own data, your own affiliated hospital's data. And also we can see the hospital's actually webpage here, like this. However, if I try to connect to the databases, I can only access my own, the affiliated hospital data only. At current, let's suppose this is the A hospital and B hospital. If I am affiliated with A hospital, only I can use my own data. So I cannot use other hospital data. If I want to use other hospital's CDM data, then I have to ask to other hospitals, and I have to wait a long time before I can get access to the data. So it is not scalable. Let's suppose, how about make this kind of walls? So I am affiliated with only A hospital, if I can access to A databases and other databases freely. So it will be amazing. So would you raise hands? Who wants this kind of research border prison? Do you want this kind of research prison? Okay. 30%, only 30%, 70% of you do not want to use other hospital data. okay, 50%. Yes. But before this kind of thing happens, we need very important we have to overcome two obstacles. The first one is this one. The hospitals participating in the CDM research border free zone apply the same policy. for internal researchers to external researchers within the research freedom. So yes, the one is big obstacles. Another one is, in case when an IRB approval or exemption is required, the hospital within the research support prison will accept the IRB approval or exemption which the lead investigator received from their institution. Please raise hands. Who believe that this can happen within this month? Raise your hand. This can happen within this year? Okay, 3, 4, 5. Oh, yes. If it happens, then when I access to the PDNet, at current, I can access only my hospital's CDM. However, it happens, then I can access other hospital data freely. Can this research prison come true? Do you believe that this research border prison can come true? No one. Someone. Yes. Okay. Now, the dream comes through now. Okay. So we have contracts on research border prison between Aju University Hospital, Jeonbuk National University Hospital, Gangwon University Hospital, Wonggang University Hospital, and Sejong Hospital, Mediplex Sejong Hospital now. Okay.
So from now on, here will be research border prison MOU signing ceremony. All proceed the ceremony in Korean. MOU 진행을 한국어로 진행하도록 하겠습니다. 저희가 이제부터 리서치 보더 프리존 MOU 사인식을 진행하도록 하겠습니다. MOU 체결을 위해서 내빈분들 참석해 주셨습니다. 내빈분들은 호명하셨습니다. 박수를 받으시고 내빈분들은 무대로 올라오시면 아한대학교병원의 김우진 의생명연구원장님, 분산형 바이오리케이트 사업단의 박내용 단장님, 세종병원의 박진식 이사장님, 아주대학교병원의 한상호 병원장님, 건강대학교병원의 윤관아 병원장님, 전북대학교병원의 박태석 빅데이터 센터장님 모두 박수로 환영해 주시기 바랍니다. 네, 지금부터 사인을 진행하도록 하겠습니다. 네, 저희 그 일곱 개 병원의 병원장님께서 이제 오셔가지고 저희가 이제 서로의 데이터를 이제 리서치 보더 프리존을 만들겠다는 MOU에 이제 사인을 하시고 계시고 각각 일곱 개 사인을 모두 다 하셔야 되기 때문에 굉장히 많은 사인이 필요합니다. 그래서 사인을 좀 진행하도록 하겠습니다. 굉장히 빠르게 이렇게 뭔가 그 뭐냐 공장처럼 이렇게 사인을 하고 계시네요. 감사합니다. 그러면은 사인이 다 끝나신 거면. 저희 그 사진 촬영을 먼저 좀 하겠습니다. 모두 다 일어나셔가지고 그러니까 한번 사진 촬영할 수 있을까요? 손을 잡고 네. 손을 양쪽 네. 네. 웃어주세요. 아디씨 네. 바쁘신 와중에도 MOU 체결식에 참석해 주셔서 감사드리고 내빈분들께 MOU 소감 짤막하게 부탁드리겠습니다.
강원대학병원 그 이승준 병원장님 대신해서 나온 그 유생명 연구원장 김우진입니다. 저희가 이렇게 좋은 자리에 같이 리서치 프리존에 참여하게 돼서 굉장히 감사드리고요. 저희 같이 이제 작은 도시에 있지만 이렇게 큰 데이터를 쓸 수 있게 되어서 굉장히 좋은 기회라고 생각하고 저희도 나름대로 또 데이터 다양성이라든지 뭐 대표성 이런 부분에 또 기여할 수 있도록 노력하겠습니다. 감사합니다.
네, 저는 해운의료재단 세종병원 그룹 박진식 이사장입니다. 저는 오늘 이 협약이 사실은 이루어지기 어려운 협약이었음에도 불구하고 이루어졌고 이 협약을 통해서 우리나라의 빅데이터 연구에 새로운 장이 열릴 거라고 생각을 합니다. 그리고 앞으로 많은 병원들 또는 많은 기업들이 이런 빅데이터 플랫폼에 같이 참여해서 더 많은 연구와 성과를 낼 것으로 기대하고 저희도 거기에 일조하고 또 거기에서 저희의 연구를 같이 해볼 수 있다는 점에서 매우 감사하게 생각하고 앞으로도 이 프로젝트가 계속 발전할 수 있도록 최선을 다해서 참여하고 노력하겠습니다. 감사합니다.
네, 반갑습니다. 아주대 학교 병원장 한상욱입니다. 우리 병원에 박내홍 교수님 같은 뭐 스타가 계시다는 게 감사하고 항상 놀랍기도 합니다. 우리 병원은 올해 의료 빅데이터 센터 또는 뭐 암 빅데이터 센터 여러 과제에도 선정 받게 되었는데 아마 이 박내홍 교수님의 어떤 그 리더십 때문에인 것 같고요. 이 사업이 계속 번창해서 많은 한국의 의료기관도 참여하게 되어서 어떤 그 CDM의 표준화 그리고 발전에 많은 도움이 되었으면 합니다. 감사합니다.
예, 안녕하십니까. 원광대학교 병원장 윤건아입니다. 오늘 이 자리에 저희 원광대 병원도 참여하게 돼서 매우 기쁘게 생각합니다. 저희 병원도 이 오디시 코리아에 일찍부터 참여해서 적극적인 활동을 해왔고 지금까지 그 CDM 데이터를 병원에 제대로 구축되어 있습니다. 이번 행사를 통해서 좀 더 그 프리존의 이 역할에 맞게 더욱 적극적으로 활동해서 우리나라의 빅데이터 사이언스에 좀 더 기여할 수 있는 그런 병원이 되도록 하고 여기 참여해 주신 모든 분들께 감사드립니다.
네, 저는 전북대학교 병원 조남천 원장님을 대신해서 참석한 전북 빅데이터 센터장 박태선입니다. 우리시 코리아를 안 거는 별로 그렇게 오래 많이 안 됐는데요. 실제로 저희가 이 지역에 있는 거점 병원으로서 적극적으로 이 빅데이터 사업에 참여를 해서 우리나라 빅데이터 산업이 현실화될 수 있는데 이익을 담당할 수 있도록 노력하는 이 모임에 저희도 참석할 수 있게 되어서 대단히 기쁩니다. 우리나라의 빅데이터 센터에 관한 법이 아직도 국회에서 계류 중인데 이 일을 시점으로 해서 그 빅데이터 3법이 빨리 현실화돼서 좀 더 쉽게 연구할 수 있는 기회가 되었으면 좋겠습니다. 감사합니다.